Samvada. Today we have a very dear friend and esteemed guest, Guru Badri Divyabhushan. Badri, namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you for being here. This is just a little candid conversation, and we are going to ask Badri some very simple questions, and we will get his take on life and dance. So, how have you been, Badri? Tell us.
It's wonderful. First of all, a big thank you for having me on this show. And big thank you to my dear friend Sushma also. This is something we didn't plan, but then I'm happy to share whatever you want me to
share with us.
Yeah, share with
you. So the last 2 years have been pretty challenging. You did a lot of virtual events and provided a platform through your dance school. So please share a few experiences about that.
It was very challenging because it was going on continuously for 3-4 months, because I said, why not have a different kind of a talk show with all these dancers, celebrity dancers and people who normally are not accessible to the general public, or probably for dance enthusiasts to see or look up to dancers. It's always like we see them perform, they leave. To know their inner self, where they do, what they did, how difficult was it for them to come to the field. So what I did was, on our Facebook page, Vishwadrithya Gana Bhushana, I posted a series of conversations with about 23 Padma Shris, Padma Bhushans, and many senior dancers, eminent dancers,
yes,
impresarios, organizers, musicians, so that they could come, and all with respect to dance, of course, and of course their personal life. So many of them cried on the show.
Yes,
of course, you know, if you remember, so many facets of life we didn't know when before they actually shared. So they started sharing so many things, and I was moved. I have cried with them, I have spoken to them and my students, and across the world, there were about 10k views every day live for the show. It was such a nice thing, because I didn't think that it will go 100. I thought first I'll do 10. I started with 10. Then after that, somebody said that we started having people telling us, you know, I would want to be featured on the show and all.
Yes, yes.
So I said, okay. Then that went on. And unassumingly, people whom we thought probably they wouldn't want to share their inner feelings or their hardships or their difficult times came up, spoke, and I thought it was 1 hour. It used to go for 3-4 hours.
It was a long
it was a long thing, and I thought how difficult it would be to, you know, I couldn't cut the guests. But then, and viewers were coming up with questions. So the segment used to be like, talk about their, not about what they did, where they did. I would always talk about their strength, their weakness, their difficult times, and how were they coping up with COVID times.
Yes.
And then what was their progressive effort towards, you know, post-COVID. This was so beautiful, like in the bargain, I would always see whenever you're talking, like how we are talking, so many things keep up, crop up, and we share our thoughts, and somewhere across the line, we gel, like we feel how similar we are, how difficult, everybody's journey is very difficult, whether it's be it small time or big time, whether they are based in India, out of India, each one's journey is so different. And sharing it for the younger generation, which looks up to these dancers, is a big task. And I was overwhelmed by all these dancers sharing it on.
Wonderful. Yes, I saw that you had, I think you got more busier.
Very.
During
the process used to be so amazing. You know how it used to be? It's like every day, me and the guest were supposed to be dressed in the same color. Our backgrounds had to be similar. And a day before, or probably that morning, I would sit through them and give them a video tour of what exactly they should do, how they should talk.
Is there anything like a word of advice that you want to give to the young generation?
See, you become, first 10 years of your life, you become a student. 20 years, you start experiencing what dance is and you become a dancer. 30th year, you start teaching and learn in the process, you become a guru. 40th year, when you celebrate dance and dance celebrates you, you become a celebrity. So it has got a very wide career path, unlike any other careers. Here, you are multitasking, I can say multitasking to the generation that talks and that we go. You are doing a lot connected with time, pace, rhythm, glamour, picturization to dancing,
it is not, it is not, it doesn't come easy. And in India, even abroad, I see this, Arangetram is not a graduation. It's just the beginning. Post your Arangetram, over the years, associate with your guru, be a part of the productions, or be a part of the journey that guru takes you along. Along with that, you have your own journey too. That gives you the spectrum to grow and to see the world. And you tell me one thing, even you are 67, you can be the Krishna. If you're fit enough, you can be the Krishna, you can be Rama, you can be Radha, Sita. So in the bargain, you get to stay healthy, you work out. And dance is something which is got the Miradhara Yoga. It's like very easily you can get into that and come out. So for honest practicing dancers, my thing is, work hard, keep up the spirits, never let anything pull you down. You might be going having a bad day, you are, you know, your things are not sitting up, but that's just one day. Yes. Every day can be glamorous, every day can be beautiful. There is always something for you to look forward to. Keep up the spirit.
Wonderful, what a wonderful, nice, cheerful, optimistic thought. So thank you very much, and I really appreciate, and I wish you and your team and your little handsome young boys all the very best, and my love to Anjana. So this is Sushma Mohan and Patrick. Thank you all for watching. This is Samvada. Namaste.
Thank you, Sushma, and thank you. I thank this channel for having me here and letting me share a couple of things for my father. Thank you.
Thank you.